हेलो स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई एम डॉक्टर श्यामसूर पटेल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ITM यूनिवर्सिटी गोलिया। यू आर इन फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर इन थर्ड ईयर, सो आई विल टीच यू इन पीपी इन प्लांट पैथोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट PP 311, दैट इज डिसीज ऑफ फील्ड एंड हॉर्टिकल्चर क्रॉप एंड देयर मैनेजमेंट फर्स्ट, इन विच वी ओनली स्टडी डिसीज ऑफ फील्ड क्रॉप। सो इन यूनिट नंबर 1 डिसीज ऑफ राइस, इन लेक्चर नंबर 2 दैट इज अ पार्ट 1। So in this lecture we studied the diseases of rice. So first I will give you the outline of the syllabus, that is introduction to rice diseases. Then what are the different objectives of today lecture? Then economic importance of today lecture. Then in today lecture we include only 3 diseases, that is rice falciparum, then bacterial leaf blight, and then bacterial leaf streak. After completion of rice diseases, I will give one exercise and I will explain the what are the learning outcome of the today lecture. Then what are the different research scope of the today lecture, that is diseases of rice, and at last we include the reference. So first one is a introduction to rice diseases. As you know that rice is a staple food and it is consumed most of the people in India. And in rice there is large number of diseases occurred, that is they occurred either by fungus or bacteria or virus or nematode. So out of that diseases in today lecture we include only rice falciparum, bacterial leaf blight, and then bacterial leaf streak. Almost 40-50% crop lost due to the diseases. So what are the different objective of today lecture? So to study the various disease of rice, in which we include only 3 diseases in today lecture, then detection and identification of pathogen, that is how we identify and detect the diseases and their pathogen. Then we study the disease cycle of the pathogen, and at last we study the management of the disease, how we manage the disease from the host or from the crop. Then what are the different economic importance of today lecture? Then as you know that rice is a staple food in India, so a number of diseases affected in a rice crop, they caused due to the virus, fungus, bacteria, and the nematode, and some environmental factor also cause malform practices in the rice crop. Almost 50-60% crop lost due to the diseases. Then one most famous example of the famine, that is a Bengal famine, which is caused due to the disease of the rice, that is brown spot of rice, that is caused by Helminthosporium oryzae. Then first disease, that is a rice falciparum. Then rice falciparum is caused by Astilagonoida virescens. This is a fungus, and the perfect state of the Astilagonoida virescens is a Claviceps oryzae sativa. I explained earlier what is a perfect stage and what is a asexual stage. So in perfect stage, in that fungus where sexual reproduction occurred, in a stage where sexual reproduction sexual reproduction performed, then we call it a perfect stage. Then what is the economic importance of the rice falciparum? Then most country in Asia, Latin America, Africa have reported the presence of the disease. So mostly these diseases occur in the Asian country, Latin America, and the African country. When a severe epidemic cause occurred, so large crop area are affected due to the rice falciparum. And in 1935 in Burma there is one epidemic caused in Burma. Then what are the different symptoms of the falciparum? Then the fungus transform individual grain into the yellow or greenish spore ball of velvety appearance, which are small at first and 1 centimeter or longer at later stage. That means the In pinnacle emergence, you can clearly see the yellowish growth in the spikelet. You can see, and these yellowish growth are replaced with the grain. At least the spore wall are covered by a membrane which are burst and spread other field or other crop. Due to development of the fructification of the pathogen, the ovary are transformed into large velvety green masses. Here, ovary are transformed into large greeny or yellowish masses. Usually, only a few spikelet in a panicle are affected, but in severe cases, when a large number of the plant are infected, then a whole panicle or spikelet are transformed into yellowish structure or some brownish structure. So whole if in severe case whole crop are affected and there is a 70-80% crop loss, crop yield loss occurred due to the rice false smut. Then what is the etiology of the Claviceps psoriasis? Then chlamydospores are formed on the spore wall. They are spherical to elliptical, waxy and olivaceous in shape. Then what are the disease cycle of the false smut? Then in temperate region, the fungus survive the winter through Sclerotia as well as through chlamydospore. Scospore produce on the overwintering Sclerotia apparently start primary infection. Chlamydospores are important in secondary infection, which is a major part of the disease cycle. Infection usually occurs at the budding stage of the rice plant and chlamydospores are born, but do not free them from the spore wall easily because the presence of sticky material. Then what are the favorable conditions of the pathogen? Then rainfall and cloudy weather during the flowering and maturity period are favorable to development of the disease. And when these conditions occurred in the field situation, then the crop are most vulnerable to that pathogen. Then how we can manage the diseases? First, we use disease-free seed for planting material, and we give seed treatment with the copper oxychloride. And if we do summer plowing in the summer, summer deep plowing in the summer, then these chlamydospores are burned due to the high heat or high sun rays. Then when we spray copper oxychloride at the rate of 3% or carbon dioxide at the rate of 0.1% at pinnacle emergence, so at that time we can manage the diseases. Second disease is the bacterial leaf blight. Then bacterial leaf blight is caused by the Xanthomonas oryzae, Pathobar oryzae. And this disease is caused by Xanthomonas, and Xanthomonas is a gram-negative bacteria, and it has a monotrichus that is only one polar flagella present on the Xanthomonas. Then what are the economic importance of the diseases? This disease was first observed in Japan in 1884, and in Indonesia we called it as Krisak disease, and in Indonesia they reported to kill young seedling and completely in 1950. In India, bacterial leaf blight was first reported in 1959, and a severe outbreak of the disease occurred in Bihar, Uttar Pradesh in 1963. In the tropics of the the disease is usually referred as bacterial blight, as it often killed entire young seedling. Yield losses is severely diseased field range from 20-30% and occasionally 50%. In India, millions of hectares are infected every year. Yield losses have been as high as 60% in some state and Godavari district of Andhra Pradesh, which are endemic of the that disease. Then touching native one, TN1 is a highly susceptible variety to bacterial leaf blight. When we grow the TN1 variety, then slowly these diseases are infected with the bacterial leaf blight. Then what is a different symptom of the pathogen? So the bacteria induce either wilting of the plant or leaf blight. Wilt syndrome become known as Kresak seedling within 3 to 4 weeks after transplanting of the crop. The Kresak result either in the death of the whole plant or wilting of only a few leaves. The bacterium entered through the hydatode and cut wound in the leaf tip because become systemic and cause death of the entire seedling. So mainly the disease occurred after 3 to 4 weeks after transplanting, and Wilt syndrome we also called it a Kresak stage. Here you see the in the photograph there is a wilting or drying symptom of the leaf you can see, and these first they are yellowing or brownish in color, then it covers to the whole leaf, and after when it covers the whole leaf of the plant, then these leaves are shed to the ground. The disease is usually noticed at the time of heading, but its severe case occur earlier also. In grown-up plant, water-soaked translucent lesion appear usually near the leaf margin. The lesion enlarge both in length and width with the wavy margin and turn extra yellow within a few days, covering the entire leaf. As the disease progress, the lesion cover the entire leaf blade, which may turn white or extra-colored. The lesion may also be seen on the leaf seed in a susceptible variety, milky or opaque dewdrop containing bacteria, mosses are formed on young lesion in the early morning. They dry up on the surface, having a white incrustation. The affected grain have a discolored spot surrounded by the water-soaked area. If the cut end of the leaf is dipped in water, bacteria would make the water turbid. Then what is the etiology of dead bacteria? So, bacteria is a strict aerobic gram-negative non-spore-forming and rod-shaped with monotrichous flagella at the one end. So monotrichous means is only one polar flagella present on the one end or one pole. The bacterial cells are encapsulated and joined to form an aggregated mass. Colony are circular, convex with entire margin, whitish yellow to extra yellow or opaque in color. The bacteria has many strains that differ in ability to infect rice plant. Strain in tropical country are usually more virulent than the those in temperate area like Japan and other South Asian country. Then what is the disease cycle of the dead pathogen? So in disease cycle, bacteria enter the plant through water pore or hydatode along the edge of the leaf and through injury in the root or the leaves. It does not enter through stomata, but a leaf blight is primarily a vascular or systemic disease. Bacterial cells move along the vascular tissue, causing wilting. Rainstorm and typhoons help in the spread of the diseases. Then irrigation water also carries the organism from field to field. The primary source of infection is through bacteria overwintering in the seed, that is a husk and induced sperm. Then bacteria may survive in the soil, plant stubbles and debris. The pathogen also survive on collateral host like Lersia hexandra, Lersia oryzoides, and Jaegina latifolia, Cyprus rotundus, Cyprus deformis, and Cynodon dactylon. And the bacteria which serve as secondary inoculum and cause secondary infection. So, as you know that when a fungal pathogen are infected to the plant, they secrete some mucilaginous padarth and they directly enter to the host cell wall or host epidermis. But in bacteria, when bacteria land onto the surface of the host, they don't secrete mucilaginous substance. They only depend on the either a natural opening, either hydatode or stomata, or injury caused by the insect or injury caused by the human or implement. So, from natural opening or wound caused by the insect, they enter into the host surface. Then what are the favorable condition to the disease? Then first, these are the disease cycle. I will explain you. Then rice plant can become infected with bacteria blight from many source disease stubbles, disease seed, paddy water, and disease strum. Then bacteria enter through the water pores or hydrothod or wound on the leaf of the root or multiply in the plant. Then high temperature and humidity during crop growth increase the incidence of the bacterial blight. Then bacteria usually inside the plant and enter the vein of the leaves. Bacteria that enter the roots plug the water conducting tissue and cause the plant to wilt. After the initial leaf lesion appear, bacteria from ooze droplets of the leaf surface and spread throughout in area by the wind or the rain, particularly typhoons and irrigated water. By this type of disease cycle continuously occurred. Then what are the favorable condition of the pathogen? Then clipping of the tip of the seedling at the time of transplanting, heavy rains, heavy dew, then flooding, deep irrigation water, and severe wind, temperature of 25 to 30 degrees centigrade, and application of excessive nitrogen, especially at the late top dressing, is very sensitive to the bacterial leaf blight, BLB, that we also called it a Kirschner disease. Then how we can manage the disease? Then grow resistant variety like Sorna, Agia, IR20, IR42, IR50, IR54, Chinsura Boro, then IET4141, IET1444, then IET2508, then and TKM6 is a resistant variety to bacterial leaf blight. Then there is some resistant donor, that is Tetep, Tendukan, and Zenith is a resistant donor for breeding problem to develop a resistant variety of the against the bacterial leaf blight. Then affected stubble are to be destroyed by burning or through the plowing. Then judicial use of the nitrogenous fertilizer and avoid clipping of the tip of the seedling at the time of transplanting is necessary to manage the bacterial leaf blight. Then avoid flood condition or drying of the field and avoid flow of irrigation water from infected to heavy field. Then third disease is a bacterial leaf streak. Then bacterial leaf streak also is called by the Xanthomonas, that is Xanthomonas competitis pathover or oryzicola. The Xanthomonas also a gram negative aerobic and they have a monotrichous flagella. Then what are the economic importance of the bacterial leaf streak? Then bacterial leaf streak was first found in Philippines in 1918. The disease is common in tropical Asia, but it is not present in Japan and other part of the world. In India, it is reported by Sri Vastava from Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Odisha, Haryana, and West Bengal. IR8, Jaya, and Padma are highly susceptible variety to bacterial leaf streak. Then what is the symptoms of the bacterial leaf streak? Then in symptom, fine translucent streak appear between the vein of the leaf are the first symptom. Here you clearly see the small translucent strip we seen in the young leaves. So this is a basic primary or initial symptom of the bacterial leaf streak. Then the lesion enlarge lengthwise and advance over large vein laterally and turn brown. On very susceptible variety in halo appear around the lesion and on the surface of the lesion bacteria ooze out and from a small yellow band like is used under humid condition we can see in the diseased plant. And in severe case the leaf may be dry up and said prematurely. Then what is the etiology of the pathogen? The organism is a short rod shape about 1.2 micron into 0.3 to 0.5 micron and it is a gram-negative bacteria. Mostly up to 85 to 90% bacteria they infected to the plant and they occur, they produce they cause the disease to the plant. Only 5 to 10% are gram positive bacteria who cause the disease, which cause the disease to the plant. So pyogenes are odd shape and gram negative aerobic bacteria, and the strain of the bacteria differ in pathogenicity, and the virulent strain causing longer streak, and the less virulent cause less streak. Then what is a favorable condition of the pathogen? Then high humidity, 83 to 93%, and dew during the morning hour from 2 to 3 hours. These are the most favorable condition for the bacterial leafy streak. Also, when we use high dose of the nitrogenous fertilizer at the time of flowering, they increase the vulnerability to causing a disease to bacterial leaf blight. Then what is a disease cycle of the pathogen? Then the pathogen can survive in infected seeds but not in the plant debris. So these are the very important point for bacterial leaf streak, that is a pathogen can survive in infected seed but not in a plant debris. The bacteria enter the leaves through stomata or wound, and it mainly infect the parenchymatic cell but does not enter the vascular system. When the leaves are wet and they exudate from the infected leaf, they spread to other portion of the leaf and to other plant. Rainstorm and typhoons favor the spread of the diseases. Then you see the in photograph or in flowchart or in a diagram, the bacteria enter the leaf through the injured tissue or leaf margin, and the bacteria multiply and even in a localized tissue just beneath the surface, and they do not spread throughout the plant like the bacteria causing bacterial blight. The bacteria ooze form small round yellow beam on the new leaf lesions, and the bacteria are spread by wind, rain, irrigation, water, and disease seed. And the high temperature and high humidity favor the disease development. These are the disease cycle of the bacterial leaf streak. Then, how we can manage the diseases? Then, glow resistant variety. So though these bacteria are seed borne, so when we use the disease free seed or without infected seed, though, so at the time of the occurrence of disease is less or controlled. Glow resistant variety IR20, Krishna, Jagannath, these are the tolerant to the bacterial leaf streak. Then affected stubble are to be destroyed by burning or through plowing. And avoid flow of irrigation water from infected to healthy field. Then avoid clipping of the tip of the seedling at the time of transplanting, and avoid flooded condition or drying of the field. Then soak the seed in streptomycin to 50 ppm and followed by the hard water treatment at the rate of 52 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes. Irrigating the seedling infection. Then spray streptocycline 250 ppm along with copper oxychloride. So by these we control or we manage the bacterial leaf streak in the rice field. So today lecture I covered bacterial leaf streak, bacterial leaf blight, and false smut. So if you have any doubt, then you contact me. Then I will give one exercise, that is a student should collect a disease sample from the rice field, and after collection they make a herbarium, and they also see the in the microscope by preparing the slide, and also they isolate the pathogen, and on the basis of symptom how we identify these diseases. You have learned or you make a flowchart. Then what are the learning outcome of the today lecture? I will explain what are the economic importance of these three diseases, and what is the symptoms, favorable condition, disease cycle, and how we can manage the diseases. Then how we can identify the various diseases on the basis of symptom, and how we can manage the diseases. These are the learning outcome of the today lecture. what are the research scope of the tutorial lecture, then to develop eco-friendly management of the toxicity, and to identify the various isolate of the pathogen, and then to identify the various botanical strict for management of diseases. So in eco-friendly management practices, we use either Pseudomonas fluorescens or Trichoderma viridis, and we see which strain are most effective against these pathogen, and after that we isolate the pathogen, and we see the which isolate of the pathogen is most virulent to causing a disease, and by fusion food technique we discover or we give the experiment to so which botanical extract are most effective against these pathogen. Then these are the reference of today's lecture, and thank you. If you have any doubt in these topics, so you can contact me and I will solve your doubt. So thank you very much.